Hi guys, I hope everyone is enjoying their evening. Thank you for inviting me to be with you. There has been a series of earthquakes along the Blanco fracture zone, 6 in total, and it started out with a magnitude 4.2 that occurred at 5:21 a.m. local time. It was followed by a 4.0 at 6:57, almost 7 a.m. local time, which was then followed by a magnitude 4.3 at 9:06 a.m. Pacific Standard Time, and then a 4.0 at 11:15 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. And as you know, any earthquake can be a foreshock for something much larger that people reportedly said they felt. The first one that occurred, a 5.5, at 1:30 p.m. local time, and then the second was almost a half an hour later at 1:57 p.m. local time. Now, I don't know if it's because the first 5.5 occurred within such a short time of the second 5.5, but 11 people reportedly felt that one, where only one person reportedly felt the second one. The moment tensor ball, according to USGS, shows spreading, and this is a spreading zone. Going to Google Earth, here's location. This is the cluster right here, the two 5.5s, the 4.4, and the other smaller ones, the 4.3. Actually, this 4.4, that was not today's series. That one was from November 21st. Now, it's hard for them to triangulate exactly how far they are and how deep they are because you need three monitors in a shape of a triangle to measure and to actually locate the earthquake. So they could be off in the location. They could be off on the depth of these six earthquakes. But you notice over here we have a trench. This is also an area of spreading. And these earthquakes were about 283 miles off the coast of Coos Bay. Let me bring this in. There'll probably be more earthquakes down the road. Who knows when? It very well could be a foreshock for something much larger. Any of these could be. But it definitely put pressure going east and west because of the spreading. And because of the tension that was applied, yeah, you can expect more earthquakes. This is also called a transform fault. Here you can see we got the spreading going on and then the different fracture zones. Here you can see the ridges that have built up because of this movement. This area does have a lot of earthquakes. In September of 2019, there was a magnitude 6.3. I'm trying to see if I can... I think originally they said it was a 5.9. So they did upgrade it. Originally they said it was a 5.4, then they upgraded it to a 5.9 or vice versa. Now they're saying it was a 6.3. There was no tsunami warning. There is no tsunami threat from these earthquakes. And more likely, there is no threat for it to cause a major earthquake along the Cascadia fault zone, but it should be a wake-up call for you guys to be prepared for a large one. So, what are your thoughts? How many of you felt these earthquakes? There, like I said, there was two 5.5s. That's the first one, that's the second one, and there could be larger ones coming. Like I said, there is a history of a 6.3 in this location. Yeah, an interesting area. So, what are your thoughts? Put those comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you.